This is not a drill. This is not a drill. General quarters. General quarters. All hands man your battle station.
Amgen to the...
Welcome to the Howdy Boomy Show. I am in the Buffalo area, and an arrest was made this morning, or last night, that's in this morning's news, about a shooter at a bar here in Buffalo called Club Marcella, and it's a gay bar. Now, in order to get in this bar, you have to go through two sets of metal detectors, two pat-downs. And somehow or another, this gentleman had a gun inside the facility and shot and killed someone. Now, someone has to explain to me why you would want to go drink, have alcohol served in a place that has to screen its clients twice with metal detectors and twice with pat-downs. You are probably safer drinking in Attica in the general population yard than you are at a bar like that. It's amazing what has happened to the world of entertainment, the world of self-entertainment. My days, you went out, you had to be 21. You always found a bar that would serve someone who could reach the bar. And you drank beer and that was it. Now, it's just absolutely amazing. You have to worry about your life. You have to worry about idiots around. Scams. Drivers from different areas that pose as drivers and kidnap people, kill people. You're better off drinking at home. It just amazes me that people go out and go through stuff like that to spend their hard-earned money to be technically entertained. Nobody expects to go out and have a couple beers and come home dead. But now, who knows what they think? Just absolutely amazing to me. I can't wait for the next presidential election, because unlike the last election, where Joe Biden hid in his cellar and the press covered for him, now he's going to have to go out there. He's got a record to run on, which is terrible. And he has to answer questions, which he can't. It was shown a couple days ago that in Ireland, he couldn't answer a question that a 7-year-old kid posed to him. Scandals. And sooner or later, something is going to break with Chinese money, Ukraine money, Hunter Biden, the influence peddling of the Biden family. Something is going to break, just like Woodward and Bernstein did in Watergate. There's going to be one thing that's going to break it wide open. And even then, the most liberal woke of presses, in order to get on the bandstand, is going to start going after him because they're going to realize he's unelectable. Hopefully, he keeps the same running mate, because she's always entertaining. She is probably the best giggler we've ever had in the White House. And between the both of them, you're going to shake your head and wonder, how the hell did these people get elected in the first place? Well, ask the New York Times. Ask the editor of the New York Times, the Chicago Tribune, the Los Angeles Times, the Washington Post, That's Jeff Bezos. He owns it. He's very liberal. What they do is anything that's anti-American, anything that's against how this country was founded and the greatness upon the values that it was developed, they're against. There was a columnist, Mr. Boyd, in the Tonawanda News years ago, said there are a million laws in the United States, federal, state, and local, on the books to enforce the Ten Commandments. So if you are a moral person, if you believe in the commandments, if you believe in law and order, they're going to rip you apart. You have to be woke. You have to be not responsible for your own actions. It's never your fault. Black Lives Matter, it's never their fault. Always somebody else to blame it on. And I was thinking about a career path. If you want to do something knowing that you're always going to have a job, I always say racism is the number one industry. It's been here forever. It's going to continue being there forever. The race card is being played more often now than Pinochle. And it's always somebody else's fault. I know some members of the Secret Service go into protesting. I remember George Bush was visiting Buckingham Palace. He was the first president to stay there. And there were protesters all across the English countryside. And they were protesting George Bush and his policies. So the Secret Service naturally has to take pictures of them. They put laser perimeters around them. And they look at the pictures. And the same people that are protesting in London, England, are the same people that protested in Spokane, Washington, and Dallas, Texas, and New York City, and Sao Paulo, Brazil. Same people. They're professional protesters. So I suggest probably get a hold of George Soros. He's probably in a book someplace, because he funds all this stuff. Anything anti-American, anything anti-moral, anything that, when you look at a chart of good and evil, falls on the side of good, he's against. He funds all this stuff. So try contact him, see how much he pays, and become a professional protester. Amazing, but that's a way to make a living. There, racism, you'll never be out of a job. I hope you have a great day. God bless you. God bless America.